This video will focus on the phenomenon known as phosphorescence. While not a topic normally covered in astronomy courses, this demonstration will allow us to observe how different wavelengths of light have different energies. In addition, many of the concepts used to talk about phosphorescence are similar to those utilized in astronomy to discuss the absorption and emission of spectral lines. Phosphorescent materials do not immediately re-emit the radiation they absorb, but do so very slowly over time. This is the mechanism behind glow-in-the-dark materials such as t-shirts and Halloween decorations. These materials are excited to higher energy states by exposure to light, and then slowly release the energy by decaying to lower energy states over time. This demonstration will make use of a zinc sulfide screen placed in a picture frame for stability and a multicolored LED flashlight. This particular LED flashlight model by Coast can emit either blue, green, or red light.
Let's explore the background knowledge needed for this demonstration with a peer instruction question. Which of the photons of light that the LED flashlight creates has the most energy? Classroom students should follow normal procedures or instructor guidelines. Viewers not in a classroom should record your vote and explain your reasoning on a piece of paper. Please pause this video and answer the question. The energy E of a photon is inversely proportional to its wavelength lambda. So the shortest wavelength photon, blue, has the largest energy, while the longest wavelength photon, red, has the smallest energy.
In a darkened room, you can see that the screen has a faint glow. It is slowly releasing energy previously absorbed when the lights were on. I'm going to start with the flashlight set to emit blue light. This is the shortest wavelength of the three colors and thus the highest energy light. I can easily use the flashlight to draw on the screen as long as I move it slowly. The smiley face will persist for several minutes. I will next change the flashlight to red light and attempt to add a hat to my drawing. Note that we cannot draw on the screen with red light. Red has the longest wavelength and thus the lowest energy of the three colors. Red and green photons simply don't have enough energy to excite the zinc sulfide to the higher energy state, while a blue photon does. More teaching materials can be found on the web at astro.unl.edu.